Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. We're back at ECR Engines where we were looking at some, well, they had some pretty catastrophic failures for some Cup Series engines. Well, actually, I'm not going to dive into it. We brought Jim back in to tell us a little bit about what the problem was. Jim, is this the problem?
Thanks, Jay. Yeah, this was the problem, but we didn't know about it at first.
Right.
It was a connecting rod bearing failure, which often are some of the toughest to diagnose with what happened, right? At 9,000 RPM, 300 degree engine temperatures, right? If an engine fails, which we obviously don't, we try to prevent that, it often ends up in a pile of rubble that you can put in your hands, right? Sometimes it ends up on the racetrack and we don't get those parts and pieces that we need. I'd like to say that we got lucky here being able to find out what happened, but it was really using the tools and resources that we had at our disposal to figure out what the root cause was. And since doing that, we've prevented future occurrences from happening.
Well, that's great. Can we dive into how you solved it?
Sure. I'm going to turn it over to my engineer, Aaron, who can tell you more about it.
Awesome. Thanks, Jim. Aaron, thanks for joining us. Appreciate
it. Jay.
Thanks for starting us on our journey.
Yeah. So in the case of our connecting rod failure, we always have to start back with what was the connecting rod like when it went into the engine, right?
Right.
And that starts with our OInspect here. So we use the OInspect. Right now we have valves on it, but when we check bearings, we'll set up a pallet of bearings to run on the OInspect. Mm-hmm. And we have all that data that's stored in our PiWeb database, and we can always go back and check that data as well. All of that data correlates to knowing exactly what's in our engine whenever we send it to the racetrack.
Sure. Yeah. And what'd you find?
In the case of this instance, the bearing was completely normal when it left this facility, so we were pretty certain that it had nothing to do with the geometry of the part when it left.
So the bearing failure was not the bearing.
Exactly.
All right, cool. Well, then you got to peel the onion and go to the next level.
Yeah, absolutely. So we'll go over to our V20 and I'll explain what we do over there.
Awesome. All right, so we're at a microscope. What did you...
Absolutely. So the first step when we get into a failure is looking into the failed components themselves and what we have to go off of. And we use our Discovery V20 as the workhorse for that. I love this thing. We can just come over here and start thumbing through the parts, finding the primary cause of the failure. And in this case, we found some debris in a bearing, which was kind of an indicator that something probably wasn't right. And I'm actually going to take you over to the sim next, where we use shuttle and find to identify a region of interest over here under the V20, and then take that for a further analysis over on the electron microscope.
Okay, so let me pause so that I understand what you did here. You took the failed bearing, put it on the light microscope, and found something that seemed curious.
Yep.
And because you knew where it was on the part, you could use a shuttle and find to do further analysis in another piece of equipment?
Exactly. There was a pretty obvious damage that meant that something got into that bearing that shouldn't have.
Got it.
And debris, our tolerances are extremely tight on our clearances, those interfaces that have to work together. And in this particular instance, it was pretty obvious that something got in there that did not
shouldn't have gotten in there.
Exactly.
All right. So you knew something was in there, but you needed to know what it was.
Exactly. That's where the sim comes in.
Cool. Let's have a look. Okay, so you found something.
Exactly. Here's the meat and potatoes. So you can see a nice color change here thanks to a backscatter image on the SEM. And the nice thing about backscatter is it'll show you differences in material composition based on their atomic weight by color. So in this particular instance, we noticed really fast that, okay, that is clearly not part of the parent material of the bearing. Went ahead and used our EDS capabilities to determine what the chemical breakdown of that debris was. Okay. And the chemical breakdown turned out to be stainless steel. That was fairly common. And in our case, we got a little lucky. It was the only part in our engine that was made out of that particular stainless steel.
Okay.
So quickly it became obvious what we had on our hands here was a failure to deburr a oil line. It was as simple as that. We had a little flake of material that was extremely small, what you would consider dust, you know, to the human eye, that had gone through the engine, made its way to the bearing interface, and embedded itself in that bearing, causing the failure.
Oh, wow. All right. My mind is exploding because, so you had a very, very specific material used in one part of your engine.
Exactly.
And you could figure out through analysis of a bearing failed component that material was somewhere where it was
absolutely
not supposed to be.
We're fortunate enough that since we do all of our own design and all of our own development, we have control over all of that stuff. We know what the parts are made of. Every part has its own QR code that we can keep up with individual components as they go into individual engines.
Wow.
Everything is tracked, has mileage. We know exactly where every part is at any given moment. And because of that, we were able to determine, based on the material in this case, that it was a simple burr that had fallen off of a part and took out an engine. It's that simple.
Caused you fits on the racetrack.
Exactly.
All right. Yep. Well, Aaron, thank you for walking us down this journey. Appreciate it. It's absolutely fascinating to see how, in the real world, you know, this equipment gets used. Appreciate your time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks,
Jay.
Hopefully, we'll see you soon.
Absolutely.
Right? All right.
Looking forward to it.
And for you out there, don't forget to stay safe, stay healthy. See you next Thursday.